Are you struggling to add new users to your software app? Do you know how they communicate with the users inside of the application that you built? What happens to those users when you add them, and where does that data go? Well, we are going to break all of this down in this video, so if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I am the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we've made it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. The biggest place that you're gonna see massive gains as you start implementing no-code is in no-code automation. No-code automation allows you to streamline your process so that all the mundane, repetitive stuff happens in the background. And I wanna teach you how to start implementing that in my free automation training. So before we get into the heart of the video, check out that automation training at garethbronovost.com/webinar-registration. I will send it directly to your inbox and you can watch that when it makes the most sense. But without further ado, let's hop into the heart of this video. We've got to talk about how you're going to gain access to your users and how your users inside of Softr, which is your front end portal, how they interact with users inside of Airtable. So let's jump into Softr and just start from scratch here. I'm gonna start a new application and I'm gonna implement a portal. I'm gonna create this client portal here. Let's go ahead and preview what this is. This is a pre-existing template from Softr, so thank you to them for putting this together. And this is great. This is what I need. I wanna jump on in and see what this client portal might look like, so I say use template. From here, it's gonna ask me for my Airtable API key. So I have to open up Airtable and go into my account. Now, once inside of here, your API key will be hidden down here. Keep that hidden. That's very private stuff. You don't want to share with anybody. Go ahead and copy it, paste it back into Softr, and it's going to do all the thinking for you. Next step is to copy this base into Airtable. So the base is where the data lives, and Softr is the front end where we're going to interact with that data. So this allows us to then copy that data schema, the actual base itself, so that we're not starting from scratch. Instead, we get the layout here that someone else at Softr has already put together for us. We've got a people table, a projects table, we have a tasks table, and we have invoices. Now, once you go to actually use your own Softr app that you're building from a template, you'll scrap all this data and start over from scratch. But for us, I'm gonna keep it in for the purpose of this example. Now, one table you always have inside of a Softr template is gonna be this people or users table. This is the table where we store the information for the people who are going to access our database. We store that information here, and that's how Softr knows who's allowed to log in. So before I move forward any further, I really need to clear the air about this because I get this email once a week from people on our email list who just don't know exactly what Softr is or how it works. The most common question I get about Softr is, do I have to pay for these people as Airtable users? And the answer is no. People are able to access your Softr app that you build in Softr, and they are not required to be Airtable users. Instead, their information just lives in an Airtable table just like this. You will be able to create the Airtable schema as we've done here from this template, and we then go into our Softr app and we grant certain permissions to people, and they can access only the data that we want them to see from Airtable. So Softr is pulling information from Airtable, displaying it to people. They can edit that information. They can create new records. They have full access as long as you want them to. You can shut down what they can do. You can say you can't edit this. You can't create new records. Or if you want them to be able to, you can. You can get as granular as you want. You can say you can edit this particular field, but you can't change this field. So Softr's incredibly powerful, and it constantly surprises me that I get these questions. So let's just go ahead and drop the mic once and for all. That's what Softr does. You don't have to pay for every user that you want to add to Softr. That is not an incremental charge. You're not charged per seat inside of Softr, and the people that you give access to your Softr app do not need to be users in your Airtable account. You can have just one user in your Airtable account and 20 people accessing your Softr app, and you're not paying for all those Airtable licenses, just the one, and the softer license. So now that we got that out of the way, let's go ahead and hop on into the next stage of this, which is going back into softer now and taking it to the next level. So we've created this base in our account and we now want to access it. So let's create the softer application. Again, this is from a template. You could just as well do this from scratch if you'd like, but I'm trying to expedite things for the nature of this video. So here we are, it's now fully created. We can go ahead and take the step-by-step tutorial for softer if this is our first time, but it's not. So I'm gonna go ahead and close that down. And where we wanna go now is to our users panel on the left. So here we see that we've got some users already in existence, and these users were ported over from the template. So I could scrap these and start entirely from scratch if I'd like. I can select all users and delete. Alternatively, I could access the portal as those different users and impersonate them if I so chose. Now, in order to start syncing up, you'll notice that this application is already connected to our people table inside of the database that we copied. So going back over to our database, this is the one that came from that template, and we already have the people table talking here. If you're starting from scratch, you need to first establish that connection. So inside of Softer, you simply go through the steps here of editing that connection. So you create the connection to the base in Airtable and then to the table that you want it to talk to. Now, before we move on, I need to mention that this is not a two-way sync. If we add a new user inside of Airtable, that user is not going to automatically pop up in Softer yet. Softer's currently working on creating a two-way sync, so at some point that will be possible. But right now, that is not how this works. In order to add new users, we must add the users to Softer, which will then create them inside of Airtable. So it's a one-way sync from Softer to Airtable. So let's now go back to Airtable and actually clear out all the data that lives inside of our people table here. I want to start over from scratch so that we can actually add these new users one at a time. So going back now to Softer, we have some options. We click on Add Users from our Users panel, and we have the opportunity to add users one at a time, which is over here, or we can click on Import Users and just drop a CSV file in and import a number of users all at once. Let's go ahead and add users one at a time. I'm going to fill out my first name and of course my user email, and I will generate a temporary password, or I can go with a magic link. I'll go ahead and make the magic link selection. It just makes logging in that much easier. I'll go ahead and save and continue. Now what's going to happen is Softer is going to take that information that I just added, this new user, and that's going to go into our Airtable base. So if I flip over into Airtable, the two pieces of information that I just added, the name and the email address, are now added here in this table. Now, if I scroll all the way over, I do have the opportunity in the future of deciding to bring in magic links and other pieces here inside of my users table. So I could, for example, say, I want to include the magic link that we created for that new user and save it to Airtable. That's a great way for us to keep track of that. So if that person ever loses the magic link, we can just go into the database, find the information, and resubmit it to them. But for now, we don't have that. So we can now choose to either create an invitation or to finish without inviting, but all this new user needs is the magic link in order to access their portal inside of Softer. So let's copy that magic link for use in just another step, and I'll go ahead and finish without inviting. It's gonna let us know that, hey, we're moving on without actually inviting that person officially, which is just not sending them an email, and I will go ahead and skip the email because I already copied that magic link. Now we need to make sure that we publish this application. So let's go on up to the top here and click publish. And once we've done that, we'll get confetti thrown on the screen because we now have successfully launched this app. But if I just go to this app without being logged in, I'm not going to be able to do anything, right? I see the landing page and I have to log in. And of course I don't have my login information. So what I can do instead is open a new tab and paste in that magic link that I have. And this is the magic link that's going to log in myself as a new user. You see, when I go to this page, I no longer have that information up at the top that says, do you want to log in or not? Now, a couple of other things. If we flip back to the data source now, We have the opportunity to create a profile photo, add a role, etc. Now, the one that I really want to point out here is the role. This is incredibly important because very often we will want to assign user groups based on their roles inside of our Airtable database. So even though we added the user from Sofdr, Sofdr then looks at Airtable and says, what type of user is this? What role do they have? And depending on the role that they have, we can actually cultivate a different experience for them. We can say managers have a certain level of visibility that's different from our clients, which is different from our consultants. Obviously, we wouldn't want to share some internal information with external parties like clients, so it's really important to designate the role here. So if I put myself as a client, I can then go back to my experience and I can refresh this page. Now, Sofdr knows that I'm a client, and look at that. It's asking me, hey, do you want to check out a project's overview? You are a client after all. Do you want to see where you're at? I can then go back to Airtable and change that up. What if I'm a manager? Go back to my logged in experience as Gareth, the user. I can reload this page, and now you see that my header is completely different. I can look at my team, I can look at my clients, and I can look at my project interview and invoices. So I have a lot more access here because I'm a different type of user, and that's all driven from Airtable. So this is a little bit confusing. The key takeaway here is we don't start adding a user inside of Airtable. We have to start by adding the users first to Sofdr. Then, once they have been built into Sofdr, they will appear inside of Airtable in our users table, or for us that was called people. And then we can go ahead and make additional changes to that user. Add their role, add phone numbers, add avatars, all kinds of additional information that can then be reflected inside of the Sofdr app itself. I know we went fast in this video. There's obviously a lot to cover here, but it's not that bad once you start rolling your sleeves up and exploring it for yourself. If you are a new Sofdr user, I encourage you to use our affiliate link. I'll include that link below the video. That is a great way for you to show some love back to the channel and say thanks for the videos. And of course, if you haven't already subscribed, please consider subscribing so that you don't miss out on future videos just like this one. That's it for this. I look forward to seeing you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.